The Supreme Bliss of Nirvana is described by the Buddha at page 476 of the Nibbana Sutta in the volume 5 of Anguttara Nikaya, saying, sukham yadettha natthi vedayitam. This verse of the Buddha means that it is a supreme bliss not to have any sensation to think of. That means Nibbana or Nirvana is a state of mind free of thinking. It is free of thinking because it is free of even sensation. Our mind thinks of things that are subject to its sensation through the information given by sensory organs. Such organs give always false information, because all our sense organs are incapable of knowing the actual nature of their objects, objects of sensation. For example, our eyes cannot see all the colors in a rainbow. When we see a jumbo jet very far above the sky, we see it as a small bird, and even the mighty sun or the moon, we see as only small objects at a distance. That means our eyes are incapable of knowing even the actual size of their respective objects when they are too far away from. So, are our ears, they cannot hear all the sound waves in the atmosphere. Our noses cannot sense even what the nose of a dog can sense. That means all our sense organs are weak and defective in their sensation, so that the information given by them are always false. It is with such false information that our mind creates mental images called thoughts, called sankappa in Pali, the Buddha's language. All such mental images deceive us. That deception is called moha in Buddha's language. Deceiving, not knowing the reality of anything that the mind becomes aware of. Ignorance, we may call it. Ignorance is named as moha in Buddha's language. Not only we are ignorant of our real nature of our mental objects, due to the ignorance, we like some objects and dislike other objects. When we like any object, we start thinking of it. Even when we dislike an object, we start thinking of it. When we like, we think of perpetuating that present object, having it even in the future. When we dislike some object, an unpleasant object, we want to get rid of them and we think of getting rid of it. How to get rid of it? and not to have it in the future. So, our mind is always thinking of sensation. As long as we are unenlightened. Thinking brings about mental tension, uneasiness, restlessness, productive of mental pains. Therefore, if we are not thinking, if our mind is not thinking, there is no mental pain, free of mental pain. And that itself is a bliss. The mind do not really think of anything when it is free of all sensation. That is what is said by the statement I mentioned earlier, sukham yadettha natthi vedayitam. The supreme bliss is not to know or sense anything by our mind, so that the mind becomes free of thinking. This is what happened to the Buddha at his enlightenment. In his first paean of joy, uttered by the Buddha after enlightenment, he had made his statement saying, what happened at the enlightenment, saying, Visankara gatan chitta. No image formations in our mind. The mind is free of image formation. Image formation means mind is free of thinking. It's a non-thinking mind. Thinking, metaphorically, is said to be speaking silently inside the mind. Inaudible speech, but the mind is speaking to oneself inside the mind, a silent speech. And that speech too vanishes when the mind is enlightened. Therefore, Buddha, not only Buddha said that enlightened mind is free of thinking. Krishnamurthi said metaphorically as a silent mind, enlightened mind. Silent mind is mind that is not speaking. It really means mind that is not thinking. Because I mentioned earlier, thinking amounts to silent talking, silent speech made by the mind. The mind think of, as I mentioned earlier, its objects, its images, when the mind likes them or dislikes them, or when the mind is ignorant of their real nature. Ignorance, as I mentioned earlier, is referred to by the Buddha as moha. The enlightened mind is free of ignorance and it is called vita moha. It is free of liking. Liking is called raga. Free from liking means vita raga. It also is free of disliking. Disliking is called dosa in Buddha's language. And the mind free of disliking is called vita dosa. That means a silent mind, not thinking. And that is a bliss. Because thinking needs certain amount of energy to heat the mind, free from heating, free from burning, at least a slight burning by that heating. even when an engine works, it gets heated. When the mind is silent, when the mind is not thinking, it doesn't get heated. It is calmed down. It is cooled down. Such a mind is a blissful mind. And that is the bliss of Nibbana. This bliss we can achieve even through practice in our day-to-day life. That is how an ascetic called Bahya in the Bahya Sutta of the Anguttara Nikaya got enlightened by listening to the Buddha, the shortest cut to Nibbana, the Nirvana. Buddha advised the ascetic not to think of what the mind becomes aware of through sensation. In Buddha's words, ditte dittamattam vaisati, when the eye becomes aware of objects, don't think of them, just become aware. Sute sutamattam vaisati, when the ears become aware of certain sounds, don't think of them. Similarly, when our nose, our tongue, our skin become aware of certain objects, don't think of them, but just be aware. When the mind remains at the level of awareness, it is conscious. It is aware. That awareness is called sati. And when that awareness is fixed in the mind, it is called satipatthana. And satipatthana, or the practicing of awareness without thinking, is the only path to Nibbana. And also it is the shortest cut to Nibbana. Just to be aware of things, but not to think of them. Or ultimately what happens when you get really enlightened, even the sensation ceases. Sensation ceases at the absorption called Nirodha Samapatti. The full term of the name is Sanya Vedayita Nirodha Samapatti. State of not being aware of sensation. Sanya Nirodha. And such a mind is alive, but not dead. It is only dormant. It remains dormant without any sensation. And that is the actual Nirvana or Nibbana, the supreme bliss of Nibbana, that can be experienced in this very life. But that experience is a negative experience, because in such a mind there is no consciousness. There is no person called I in that. All sensation vanishes. And such a state is a supreme bliss. And that is nothing but the bliss of Nirvana, the bliss of Nibbana. Nibbana means, ni means negation, no, not having. Bana means bondages, free from all bondages. The mind is bound to nothing. The mind is completely free. It's called Parama Vimukti, ultimate freedom of the mind, free of all attachment. Attachment is called raga in Pali, and such a mind is vitaraga, free of attachment. Free of attachment means free of resentment too, because we resent things that we can get attached to. We resent things, we dislike things that we cannot like. Therefore, resentment is based on attachment. Disliking is based on disliking. And both of them are based on the ignorance of the reality of things that our sense organs experience and inform our mind defectively to create false, defective mental images which are not real, though they look real, they are only delusions. Therefore, mind that is free of delusions, we may call it moha, ignorance, having no mental images, is a mind that is completely free of its content. Our mind contains mental images, thought forms. Non-thinking mind is an empty mind, empty of mental objects. And that is nothing but Nirvana, Nibbana in Pali. Therefore, Nirvana or Nibbana is described as sunyata, meaning voidness. Sunyata is Pali and sunyatva in Sanskrit, empty of its content. A mind that is free of its content is the supreme bliss with nothing to think of, nothing for sensation, mere emptiness. And that mind is called sunyata loko by the Buddha. Loka means the mind of the Buddha. Sunyata loka means an empty mind. Such a mind is described by in the Mahasunyata Sutta as well as in the Chula Sunyata Sutta. Sunyata means the supreme bliss of Nirvana, free of sensation. Free of sensation means free of thinking. Free of thinking means free of all mental pains, through tension, through the mind becoming burdened by thought forms. Free of all burdens is an empty mind. And that is the supreme bliss of Nibbana, or the supreme bliss of Nirvana, or the supreme bliss of enlightenment that we can achieve. And we can practice reaching such a mind as advised by the Buddha to the ascetic Bhaya in the Bhaya Sutta, saying, first stage, be aware, but don't think of what you become aware of. Ultimately, when there is nothing to be aware of, the mind becomes free of all sensation. And that can be achieved in this very life at the trance called Nirodha Samapatti. And it becomes permanent and eternal after Parinibbana, the final passing away of an enlightened mind. What an enlightened one can experience in this life is the supreme bliss of Nirodha Samapatti, where there is no sensation to think of. And such a mind is a thoughtless mind. Krishnamurthi referred to it as a silent mind, non-talking mind. Non-talking mind means non-thinking mind. And that is the state of the supreme bliss of Nibbana.